We are talking about a systematic and methodical method of genocide that today uses more subtle tools than it did 200 years ago. And systematic and methodical it is. Our people, and every day, everywhere they turn, are being told, you are not good enough. You are not valuable as a Native person. Your language, your culture, your history, your customs, your ceremonies, none of those things are valuable. Even the way you look is wrong. The way your skin color is wrong. The way you dress is wrong. The things you eat are wrong. And in order to be any kind of a human being, any kind of real person, you have to dress a certain way. You have to look a certain way. You even have to pitch your voice a certain pitch. Because if you look too Indian, if you look too Native, then there's something wrong with you. There's something really wrong with you that you are not going to be able to succeed to do anything. You'll never be any good at anything. You're ignorant, you're savage, you're primitive, and you always will be as long as you're Native. That's the subtle message. And sometimes it's more than subtle. Sometimes it's blatant in the legislative process, in the bureaucratic processes, in the instruments that they use in the schools. It's either you become like them, become white, non-native, or you're nothing. You may as well die. You may as well commit suicide, be a drunk or whatever. Because if you're anything else, then you're ignorant, you're savage, you're valueless. And the thing about that is that they have every way of telling you that. Every way of showing you that. Every way of making sure you understand that you know your place, that you can only succeed if you become like them. We are valuable. We're much more valuable and much more precious in what we have today than ever before, and that becomes more and more clear to me as I look at the world and I look at the systems and I look at the sickness there and I look at the healing that needs to be done. And the onus is on each one of us. The onus is not on someone else. We cannot say, well, who am I to do anything about it? I'm just one little person. I can't change the system. I can't do anything about it. Every one of us has that responsibility. Every one of us can take on that responsibility. Every one of us responsible, whether we want to be or whether we don't want to be. Things happen through action or non-action. It's your choice. You can be a teacher, and you're always a teacher, no matter what you do, no matter if you don't want to be. You are. You either teach good or you teach bad. Because people around you are affected by what you say, by what you do, by how you are, the things that you work at, the things that you promote, the things that you represent.